Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to explain the process of procuring import material, and by the end of this video, you will get to know what are the steps involved in procurement of import material, what are the accounting entries generated at different steps, and also you will get to know what is landed cost for import material and how it's created or recorded. So let's continue with the process. Let's take an example of procurement of steel coil, which is import material. The first step is to create the purchase order using import purchase order type. In this, you specify the foreign vendor from which you have decided to procure the material, your material, its quantity, and the net price for the material. The second step is to maintain the condition rate. The condition rates are used to record the landed cost for the import material, such as insurance cost, custom duty, or transportation cost. All these costs are recorded on the basis of provision, since we don't have the actual price for them at the time of PO creation or good receipt. So these are calculated on the basis of setting them in Incoterms and picked up into the purchase order. You can change the price if you want in purchase order. Like in this example, I'll change the custom duty from 1000 to 1100. Now the total landed cost, which is 3000, is changed to 3100. The third step is to record the good receipt against the import material, which is done by the store department, and the accounting entry generated here is debit material plus landed cost credit GRIR account with an amount of 5000 USD plus 3100 local rupees, which is landed cost. Now the next step is to record the multiple invoices from the import vendors that include material cost, which is booked against the foreign vendor, the insurance cost, which is booked against the insurance vendor, the custom or duty paid for the material, which is booked against the custom vendor. The last is recording of transportation cost, whose invoice amount is changed to 2000. And the accounting entries generated for all these invoices are debit GRIR clearing account, credit vendor payable account. Except for the transportation invoice, whose invoice amount is changed from 1500 to 2000, and the accounting entry generated for this is debit GRIR clearing account with 1500 amount, debit material with 500, which is a price difference, and credit vendor payable account. If we analyze this entry, we can see 500 amount, which is a difference amount for transportation cost, is now incorporated into the material, which is previously booked at 1500 transportation cost. Now it's updated to the actual or invoice amount. In case if the material is consumed or is not available in the inventory, then this 500 amount difference is goes to the price difference account rather than going to the material account. Now if we see the balance of GRI account, we can see the account balance becomes zero. Now the last step is the payment of invoices to the relevant vendor, and the accounting entry generated over here are as follows. For import vendor, debit vendor payable, credit bank outgoing account. Similarly for custom vendor, for insurance vendor, and for transportation vendor, the accounting entry is same, that is debit vendor payable and credit bank outgoing account or cash account. Thank you for watching the video. Hope you found this knowledgeable and useful. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video.